What's up, everyone? Sam here from ByteByteByte.com. If you've ever gone into your interview and as soon as you were in there realized, holy crap, I don't remember any of the things that I studied, in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how to avoid that, so stay tuned. All right, so in this video, what I want to talk about is this thing where we tend to study and then not actually remember most of what we've studied. And I want to show you a specific technique that you can use to make sure that as you are studying, you are ensuring that you're actually remembering everything that you study and that you're not going to forget it as you go into your interview. Because this is super, super important, right? I talk to so many people who they'll go and spend like 8 hours on the weekend and they're going to say, okay, this Saturday, I'm going to spend 8 hours studying trees, for example. And then 2 days later, by the time they get to Monday or Tuesday, they've actually forgotten like nearly half of what they learned. And the problem here is not only that they don't remember what they learned, but now they just wasted all of this time on the weekend studying when they could have just not done it, right? Because they didn't get the results from actually studying. So what was the point in doing that in the first place? And I want to talk about why that is. So the number one reason why we tend to not remember a lot of what we learned is because of illusions of competence. And this is a term that I learned in, there's a course on Coursera called Learning How to Learn, which is a great course if you want to go deeper on the specifics of like, you know, how we learn, what the psychology is behind it. But one of the things that they talk about is this idea of illusions of competence. And so what are illusions of competence? Well, basically, the issue that we have a lot of times is that the way that we learn is that we read stuff, right? You'll go into the textbook, you'll read the textbook, and let's say that you're trying to learn about merge sort. You'll read about merge sort, and you'll basically say, okay, that makes sense, right? I read through it, I understood what they were talking about. All the points that they made connected properly, it all made sense to me. I understand how this works. And so we say, okay, I understand this well enough that I can go on and that I can basically move on with my life and move on to studying something else. And the same is true when we go on LeetCode, code, right? We'll do a LeetCode code problem and maybe we get stuck partway through. And so we go look at the solution. Fairly typical approach that most people take. You look at the solution and you're like, oh, this solution makes sense, right? Anytime you're saying like, oh, this makes sense, that might clue you into the fact that that doesn't actually mean that you know the thing. It just means that it makes sense when someone else describes it. And so the problem here, of course, is that when we look at something and it makes sense to us, that doesn't actually mean that we have internalized it and that we understand the logic. And more importantly, it doesn't mean that we can actually reconstruct that logic after the fact. And so it's so important as we're going through our studying that we make sure that not only are we learning the thing and not only are we studying, but that we're actually making sure that we are embedding this knowledge and that we truly understand it at a deep level. And that's what I want to talk about right now is I want to talk about a specific strategy that you can use to make sure that you're actually learning the things that you're learning and that you're actually really embedding that knowledge in your brain. And so the technique that we're going to talk about is called recall. And if you've ever heard the idea that like the best way to learn something is to teach it to someone else, this is actually a very similar concept, although you don't have to involve anyone else and you don't have to like muddle through and embarrass yourself in front of your friend who's like trying to learn this thing from you and you don't really understand it yourself. And so the way that this works is that we're gonna start with a topic and you wanna get as specific as you can about the thing. Right? Because the more specific you get about the topic that you're going to learn, the easier it is for you to learn that topic. And so let me give you an example. Maybe something that would be really specific that you would say, I'm going to learn how to solve this problem. I'm going to learn how to solve the 0-1 knapsack problem. I'm going to learn how to solve, you know, the longest common subsequence problem. And so that's what I'm going to learn. Or maybe you say, I'm gonna learn this specific algorithm. Like, I'm gonna learn merge sort. I'm gonna learn how to reverse a linked list. It doesn't really matter what it is, but you wanna get to something that is like specific enough where you can say, okay, I'm gonna go through this particular thing. And so that's step one, is get specific on what you are trying to learn. Now, step two is that you're going to study the thing, right? Because you don't already know how to do this, presumably, or if you already knew how to do this, this wouldn't be necessary. And so you're gonna go and you're gonna find a resource that will teach you the thing. And so maybe that resource just looks like the code itself. Like maybe you're on leak code and you're looking at the solution and you're just reading through the solution code and you're like, I'm going to go through this solution and I'm going to study it and make sure that I understand it. And so the purpose here is basically you're going to study it as best as you can and maybe take 15 minutes to actually study the topic. So first, we clarified what the problem was, and then we studied the specific problem. And you want to study the specific code and really make sure that as best as you can, you actually understand what's going on. And then the next step is that we're going to close the book, we're going to close the website, we're going to put everything away, and we are going to now try and recreate what we just studied. And so I'll use the example of merge sort here. Let's say that I went into my college like data structures and algorithms textbook and I read the section on merge sort. And so I went through the code, I walked through some different examples. I'm feeling good about this. So now I close the textbook, I'm gonna get out like a sheet of paper or open a blank text editor, whatever you wanna use, and I'm gonna try and code it up now from scratch. So I'm gonna code up merge sort from scratch, and now one of two things is gonna happen. Either it's gonna go great. And that's awesome. If it goes great, that means that I actually understand it, right? Because I was able to recreate it based on what I had studied in the book. And so now I can feel good about it. I can feel like I didn't need all these cues that were in the book and cues from looking at someone else's solution to actually get to a solution of my own. And so I can feel confident that in an interview or later on, I know enough that I can recreate this solution myself. So that's the best possible outcome. But the other possible outcome is that we're going through it and we get stuck somewhere. So maybe there are like easy parts. So let's say we're talking about merge sort here. Maybe I'm okay with the function definition. I'm okay with the breaking the arrays apart, but I get stuck on the how am I gonna merge the arrays back together. And so what you're gonna realize, and the key and one of the biggest benefits of using this strategy is that you're going to identify specifically what you are stuck on. And so it's no longer a question of, I generically don't understand merge sort, or I'm just confused. You're now saying, okay, I don't know how to merge these two arrays together, but I understand the rest of it. And so you're gonna go through, you see where you get stuck, and now you can go back and basically cycle back to the second step. So remember, we started with clarifying the problem, then we studied the problem, then we tried to solve it, and now if we're stuck, we go back to studying the problem some more. But now, here's the beauty of it, is that now we know exactly what we need to study, right? We're no longer studying everything. We're no longer just generically trying to go through. We're specifically identifying, here are the areas that we got stuck. So let me study those and make sure I understand those as well as I can. And then we repeat the process again. We close the book, we do the recall, we try and recreate it from scratch. And by doing that, we're gonna continue this loop until we fully understand every part of the problem and we can recreate the problem from scratch. And this is how we avoid illusions of competence. This is how we avoid convincing ourselves that we know something, because when we see the like anchor points, our brain can latch onto it and say, oh yeah, that makes sense. And we can actually recreate something from scratch. Because if you think about it, it's way easier, for example, to read a good book and understand that it's a good book than it would be for you to write your own book. And so there's a very different way that our brain functions when it comes to understanding something versus creating something. And this is what we're playing off of here, is that it's so important that your brain actually, that you train your brain to be able to create and not just to understand. And so this is the technique I want you to actually put this into action today. Try this with one problem that you've been struggling with. And then the follow-up to this that I also want to point out real quick is that once you've done this once, you're going to want to come back to the problem occasionally. You don't have to do it every day. You don't have to do it that often. But your memory, even if you do understand the thing, is going to fade over time. And so a good goal for you should be, once you've learned something, come back to it once a week. It's not gonna take you very long. And as you do it more often, you're gonna just be quickly like refreshing your memory rather than actually having to relearn anything. So it should be pretty fast for you. But I would highly encourage you to take this approach, explore how you can use this to really understand every problem that you go through. And what you'll find is that it's gonna take a lot longer up front, but you're gonna remember way more of what you studied. So it's actually gonna save you a lot of time in the long run. And so with that, that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the subscribe button below. And we also have our free 50 interview questions guide, where I walk through every single of 50 of the most common interview questions. I'd highly encourage you, click the link below, check that out. And I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.